Hey everybody, welcome back to Shrek and Donkey Slayers Gaming. I'm your host, jfolcarelli89, and today we bring you the Tabletop Racing World Tour review. This is one of two games picked for PlayStation 4, the PlayStation Plus free games for the month of May. Hope everyone is having a good one. And thanks again, everybody, for the recent subscriptions. Much appreciated. As we check out this, we will be also checking out Tropico 5, I believe, as well. So, what Wikipedia says about this game, it is actually based on a series that came out. The Tabletop Racing started off in 2013. This is a racing video game developed and published by Playrise Digital LTD. The game was originally developed for the iOS platform on January 31st, 2013, and later released for Android devices on January 23rd, 2014. PlayStation Vita version was released on August 5th, 2014. And then the game that we are playing today, the second game in the series, Tabletop Racing World Tour, was announced in October 2014 for release on PC, consoles, and mobile platforms. So this is a single player and online multiplayer, and it's best described as an environment for the Micro Machine series. And also similar to the Mario Kart series as well. Let's see. The player controls a miniature toy car with tracks comprising various elements of a larger structure, such as a kitchen table, a garage workbench, a Japanese restaurant, a picnic table, much like Mario Kart. Cars have simple arcade-like controls. The player has two options as to how to control the car's tilt features. Steering, and that's for the iOS, actually. People that created it actually worked on the Wipeout series as well, on that, so this is one of the free games. This is my review of it, so let's get right to it. Thanks, everybody, for watching. Much appreciated. And as always, if you haven't liked us on Facebook, do so. Check us out on YouTube. Give us a subscribe. Right now, we are live on Twitch. So you can follow us there as well. Much appreciated. And Twitter as well. Check out all those media outlets and like, subscribe, do what you got to do on those so you can be up to date with us. I'll also have Tropico 5 as a review as well. And my co-host Goodman Lior will probably do reviews as well of these two games. That's what usually goes on, and he is about to put out Uncharted 3 as well. And actually, as of May 10th, I think they are releasing May 10th. I believe they're releasing Uncharted 4. Also, we have an open beta that will be coming, and that is Overwatch. From May 5th to the May 9th, I believe it said. So you'll get to play that for 4 days as well. So that's pretty cool. I'm also doing Plants vs. Zombies, Garden Warfare 2. And I'm still playing as well MLB The Show, mostly Road to the Show at this point, in terms of that. Again, thanks everybody for watching. Much appreciated. And people that are wondering about, we still have a shout out Saturday that will happen. We're not sure when it could be. We were thinking of possibly doing it as a pre-record, because our weekends are pretty busy, but hopefully we can try to squeeze one in, because subscriptions are building up, and we might have a long list of that as well. And we also need to get some more Destiny gameplay in as well. So let's get right to it here. I'm at the beginning screen. Welcome to TTR World Tour. And X button to start. Let's get started. To start racing, you first need to buy a new car. Here's 13,500 coins to get you going. You can win more coin through racing. You can find all the available cars in the garage. Let's go shopping. So, what do we have? 13,500. So we can get this bug rat. This great starter car has bags of personality and gives a good all-around performance. It's trusty, reliable racer, and the driftability is average. And then we have the Leviathan, a quick, slow off the line, but quick once it's get a little slow off the line, but quick once it gets going. It's a solid, stable racer with a long and successful pedigree. Driftability poor. And then we have the Breaking Bad. Wow, okay. You'll have your work cut out for you with this lumbering, crazy classic. It is difficult to master, but very fast once tamed. Driftability is average. And then we have the Brawler. This cool, classic American muscle car has power, looks, and resilience in a close fight. It can be a little tricky to master at first due to a hint of understeer. Driftability is good. What am I going to pick for this? Oh, there's different classes too. Oh, these are way expensive. The higher end cars are way up there. Look at this. So we're in the amateur league, so what am I going to pick? Am I going to pick this buggy? I'm between the buggy and the muscle car, and if for some reason I'm going to have to go to the buggy. I don't know why, but I think I'm going to do it. And I'm going to go for the buggy. I'm going to buy the bug rat. Let's race. Select championship from the menu below and discover the world of TTR racing. Win coins, trophies, and unlock more races by competing in race events. Earn apparent experience points to unlock more special events. Got it? Okay. Anyway, I just earned a trophy, not sure what, so there is trophies to this. I'm going to go to championships, cult classic, Splack Pug trophy. Championship. To win a championship trophy, first you need to beat all the events leading up to the finale with a minimum of a bronze star. Win stars, earn coins, upgrade your car, and win events to unlock new championships and buy new cars. Okay, got it. Combat Race features a full grid of mayhem with a range of offensive and defensive power-ups. Collect power-ups by driving through the pickup bubbles. Take your time to learn how to use each pickup to use power-ups by pressing the fire button. Okay, got it. Okay. Race. Opponents. Pickups allowed. So I see where they get the Mario Kart version of it. You got the pickups. A bomb, a speeder, a missile, things like that. Let's get right to the race. Accelerate, power up the fire is X, brake is L2. Press X to start. Okay, starting off here, the mechanics are pretty smooth. I like racing games, so this is definitely for me. Definitely has the feel of Mario Kart with the three shots, man. Off the missile. Whoa. Yeah, it's a little fun game to play. I mean, this is pretty good. I wonder how it does with multiplayer, online multiplayer. We may have to check that out, actually. waiting for race to finish. I think that we already won the race. Skip to results. Nice. So I got first place on that. Prize coins, 2,500, and got another trophy. Nailed it. Pretty cool. So go to the next race. Pretty easy, pretty simplistic. This is my kind of game. I like racing games, so this is pretty cool. Time trial. Alrighty then. So we'll check out some more of this. Pretty cool, and it's very basic, basic controls. So for some reason I'm in time trial. Oh, this is I'm actually on a table with plates and stuff. This is really cool. Okay, I want to do the race. So I want to race. This is time trial. Are you sure? Yes. Quit. Okay, I guess I gotta do the check mark instead. I guess this is the next race. I don't know. I was thinking it was like just a continuous deal, but I guess not. But yeah, I'm liking this. I'm liking it. This is definitely my thing. And I don't know if this is the same race or not. It kind of looks like it. God, it's a quick game. A big battery right there. Alright, just use the brake too. The brake is actually pretty good. It's L2 if you're doing L2 on a PlayStation 4. I think it's speed boost, yeah. It's coins. Got a missile, let's see how it works. Definitely slowed him down. Waiting for the race to end. So maybe I do have to do the time trial, which I didn't think you did, but oh, the race is right here, that's why. I think this is the race. Hot lap race. You get 90 seconds to give up your fastest lap. This is weird. I guess I gotta do the time trial. I don't know. We'll just do it even though I just got out of it. Ooh, just, I'm on an oven. I just hit an oven with a thing of steak. A wallet, and the stop is actually pretty sensitive. I just stopped, almost came to a complete stop very quickly. pukes a zucchini there. Guess we have to do these to unlock the other things. You've got 90 seconds to put in your best lap. Generally, the powerhouse will be the turbos, but choosing the best place to use them can be crucial for this. Okay. Game board, maybe? Like a kid's room. Bad idea to use those. Okay, let's keep it going here. Can we do this? We got 19 seconds to complete this. Complete? I don't know. I thought I completed. Did unlock the next race. So we'll keep it going. I'm enjoying it pretty well. I mean, this is something. Check out the multiplayer, but I think it's a pretty cool game. Something. I don't know if I would pay for it. Would I pay for it? No, free. Yes. I mean, there isn't much to the game, as you can tell. I would probably play this as a mobile game, definitely. Which I might actually do a review on that. On the iOS game, I mean the Android game, to check it out. To try to compare and contrast. Should it be in a platform? Probably not. I don't know how much they charge, what they're charging for this game. Actually, I think it might have been $19.99, if I'm not mistaken. I know the Tropico 5 actually is at regular price. Well, this month they have it for free. And I've never heard anything about that. We'll be checking that out as well. Be on the lookout for that review as well. And also be on the lookout for Goodman Leor's review on these games. He'll be sure to check them out as well. He usually does. I'm big into racing games, and this is just a basic game, and I have Mario Kart myself. And play that a lot of times. But this is fun. Would I pay a big amount of price for it? Probably not. And as you can tell, there is a music background to this, but I do have it off because it does get flagged by YouTube for copyright issues. But yeah, this is a game I think I'll check out, and I think we could do a multiplayer review on this. Which would actually be very cool. Let's see, Hot Lap. This is another 90 second race here. We'll just check out this circuit of events and see what happens when we do win, and then you can check it out as well. Here's another race. This looks like a something on a yacht, probably. This is cool, like a little thing on a yacht with fruit and some shrimp cocktail and some wine. Check this out. Some watermelon, some meat. It's like a picnic on a yacht. Buns right there that we just went by. Might not have been the best idea to hit that. Piece of cheese. This game isn't no NASCAR or Gran Turismo or Need for Speed, but it's something that's pretty cool. It's very unique. And I can see where they get the tabletop deal and everything, so that's cool. I understand what they are doing, so that's cool as well. Got the first place, the bonus coins, the XP. Yeah, so we'll do the trophy finale. Beat the other races to the finish line. No power-ups at all. Just pure driving skill. Clean racing optional. And we'll play the finale, and then we will end the video. Give my rating. It'll be on a 1 to 10 scale. And an overall a review on that. Let's see what it looks like. Actually, this is a one that we've already done. This is like probably like a junkyard or body plant. I just crashed. Might not be good because I might not. You have to come in first place and all to get into the finale. So we may have to retry this one if I can't catch up. Looks like it's very easy to catch up because 4 laps. I mean, there's pretty good detail with the vehicles, even though it's like the basic. But they put a lot of detail into the name of them, like the Breaking Bad. That's pretty cool. And the muscle car. I see. I'm in third place. I'm in the second. Pulled in the first to win it. And just pulled that win out. And it should probably most likely does get a lot harder when you go deeper into the game, I must think. So we'll go on to the finale. The Spark Pug Trophy Finale. And there's our amount. We have made $19,050. Championship Finale. Take your place on the podium. This is the ultimate multi-race challenge. You'll earn points based on your finishing position for each race. These points add up from one race to the next. The driver with the most points after the final race wins the championship. Win trophies, big coin prizes, and unlock new championships. This is five laps back in the 80s. Okay, so you have to do all these races. The Chop Shop, Unthinkable 2. I guess it's a few races. It's like a circuit. This is what I thought it was. So championship finale. This is a multi-race combat event. So I think it's three races that you have to do. Like Mario Kart, if you're doing one of the circuits. It's a little more difficult. This is a little hotter. Just froze three people. That was cool. I'm in second place right now thanks to that freeze. Ugh, off the track. What happens when you're off the track? Now I'm in fifth. Got the freeze coming off. I gotta do it soon. Missed it. Waiting for the race to end, so I come in fifth place. So it's definitely more difficult. Skip to results. So I'm in fifth. 75 XP and bonus coins. Get 6 points out of that. So a three race circuit, not bad at all. And a challenge, which is pretty good. There's like the body shop mechanic one again. Someone just shot me with the mine attack, so you slow down. Third place. You get points when you do make an attack. Someone slipped on my oil spill, so I got some XP and some coins for that. Coming second now in that one. So fifth and second. move up a little bit, but it's going to be tough. Well, now actually in second place, race 2 of 3 with 30 points behind, well, 12 points behind. The PR, that racer, has 30 points. We're going to need a first place finish and him to struggle a bit. And has the yacht thing with the little picnic. Pickup trucks and set in first. Targeted. Ah, by the bomb. Not going to catch up with them, but we'll stay in second. Not sure if it's going to be enough to take first place. Skip to results. And race results. Came in third place. Labralda PR1 with 36. The Leviathan TT with 31. And me there at 30, so third place on that one. The rest of the cars, I guess, get thrown into a bucket. Congratulations, you won the bronze spark plug trophy. $26,350. Twin Cam Challenge, congratulations, new champions. Chip unlocked. You can now use any car in the Spark Plug Trophy Championship. Great if you need to go back and get 3 stars on everything, okay? Pretty cool. Spark Plug Trophy came in third place. I want to go back and check it out. I can. We can look also. And then you got different. So 1 and 2. I mean, this is a short game. Expert, Supercar. And then you got the Garage. DLC Shop. Still can't buy nothing in that area, so I can save on that. You got the multiplayer and then special events, cult classic. Special events, okay, cool. So there is a lot of gameplay that can be put on this, and then let's see, go back, multiplayer. Join game, host game, so people can join you. That's pretty cool. So what am I going to give a rating on this? I'm going to have to give it out of 10 stars, 6. To me, it's probably going to be lower on other people's lists, but I like racing games. The racing is smooth on this. It's basic. It's cool. But would I pay $60 for it? No, I wouldn't. Would I pay 20 for it? Probably not. But in general, the game is pretty cool for a freebie. Download it for the month of May. You'll get to keep it in your library. So check that out. So 6 out of 10. Everybody check out this game. Tabletop Racing World Tour. And you can also check it out on your tablet or phone, and your Android or iOS stores. Check it out. So there's your review on the Tabletop Racing World Tour. Thanks, everybody. Hopefully, everyone is liking these reviews. If you haven't yet, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Twitch. As we constantly go live. Thanks everybody for watching. Much appreciated. And as always, happy gaming.